हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मनोज कुंडारे, द असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक साइंस। वेलकम बैक टू आवर ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कन्वर्जन ऑफ ग्रे कोड टू बाइनरी नंबर एंड बाइनरी नंबर टू ग्रे कोड। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक, द कन्वर्जन ऑफ बाइनरी टू ग्रे कन्वर्जन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नो द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द ग्रे कोड। वी हैव सीन द डिटेल्स अबाउट द ग्रे कोड। As it is a non-weighted code, it has a very special feature that only one bit will change each time the decimal number is incremented. As only one bit changes at a time, the gray code is also called as the unit distance code. The gray code is a cyclic code. This all information is seen previously. Let's see the basic procedure in binary to gray conversion. There are some rules. First step is record MSB as it is. That means whatever is the MSB of gray or whatever is the MSB of binary is as it is at the MSB of gray. The next step is add this bit to the next position, recording the sum and neglecting any carry. And the third is record successive sum until completed. Let's see the example here. Convert 1001 binary into gray. Write out the binary number as it is, that means 1001. The MSB is as it is, that means here is 1. Here perform the XOR operation between this 1 and 0. We know that 1 XOR with 0 results 1. Okay, then perform XOR operation between this 0 and this 0. We know that the XOR operation 0 XOR with 0 results 0. Now perform 0 XOR with 1. That means 0 XOR with 1, we get here 1. That means in this case we get the equivalent gray code 1101. I hope you all remember this conversion. Now let's start our today's topic. The question is that design binary to gray code converter by using KMAP method. Let B0, B1, B2, B3 be the bits representing the binary numbers, where is the B0 is LSB and B3 is MSB. Hence B3, B2, B1, B0 is a binary number, where B0 is LSB and B3 is MSB. Similarly, let G0, G1, G2 and G3 be the bits representing the gray code for the binary numbers, where G0 is the LSB and G3 is the MSB. That means the gray number is G3, G2, G1 and G0. Here G0 is LSB and G3 is MSB. Okay. Now, first of all, the first step is write the truth table for the binary to gray code. Here the binary number is, first binary number is 0000. Write out the MSB as it is 0. Then perform the XOR operation between this 0 XOR with 0, we get here 0. 0 XOR with 0, we get 0. 0 XOR with 0, we get 0. Hence we get 00000. Okay. Now consider the next case. The next binary number is 0001. Here write the MSB as it is 0, then 0 XOR with 0, we get 0. The 0 XOR with 0, we get 0. And here 0 XOR with 1, we get here 1. Hence we get the gray code 0001. Consider the next case here. 0010. Here write out the MSB as it is, that means 0 as it is. Then 0 XOR with 0, we get 0. 0 XOR with 1, we get 1. 1 XOR with 0, we get 1. We get the code 0011. That means we get 11. Similarly, let consider this situation here, 1010. Okay, consider here 1010. 1010 10. Here, write out the MSB as it is. Now perform the XOR operation. 1 XOR with 0, we get here 1. 0 XOR with 1, we get here 1. And 1 XOR with 0, we get here 1. That means we get the gray code 1111. For this combination, we get the gray code 1111. I hope you all understand how to write this table. Okay. Now, the next point is write out or find the KMAP for each bit of the gray code. The first is find the KMAP for G0. Here, consider only the G0 column and write the KMAP for it. Here, the binary inputs are B3 to B2. That means this is B3, B2, B1 and B0. And we know the combinations as 00, 01, 11, 10. 00, 01, 11, 10. Then put the values of 1 here. G0 is equal to 1 when we get this combination. That means 00, 01, 00, 01. Here we can write 1. Okay. Put this one for this combination 0010. That means 0010, we get here 1. Then next one is here 0101 0101, hence next one. Put next one for 0110 0110 0110 is here. Okay. Put next one for the combination 1001 1001. For this one 1010 1010. Then put next one 1101 1101, and the last one is here 1110 1110. Okay. And the other remaining places are 0. Okay. We get 2 chords here. Okay. Let's simplify these chords. This is the KMAP, and after this KMAP we can find here that the equation for this chord is spread into 4 rows, hence all B3 and B2 cancels each other. Only the equation of this chord is B1 bar B0. Okay. Similarly, the equation of this chord is B1 B0 bar. That means B1 bar B0 plus B1 B0 bar means B1 XOR with B0. Okay. Then find the KMAP for the gray code or gray bit G1. Then we have to find the KMAP for only this column G0. Put this one, first of all write the binary B3, B2, B1, B0, 00, 01, 11, 10, 00, 01, 11, 10. Put first one is here for this combination 00, 10, 00, 10. This is the first combination. The next one is 00, 11. 0011, that means 0011. The next one is 0100, that means 0100, this box. Next one is 0101 0101. Okay. The next one is here, and the combination is 1010 1010. This is the next combination. The next combination is 1011 1011. Okay. Now put this one 1100 1100, and the last one is 1101 1101. Okay. The other places are having value 0. Then we get here 2 chords also. This is the one chord and this is the next chord. Okay. Let's simplify this KMAP. This quad is spread into the two rows. That means here B3 changes from 0 to 1. Hence we get here only B2. And in this side it's spread into two column. Here B0 changes from 0 to 1. Hence here we get B1 bar. Okay, that means B2 B1 bar. Okay, for this chord, this spread into the two rows where B3 changes from 0 to 1. Hence it gets cancelled. Hence we get here B2 is equal to 0. Hence B2 bar. Here it's spread into two columns. Here B1 and B0. B0 changes from 1 to 0. Hence B1 has the value 1. Hence we write here B1. B2 bar B1. And we know that B2 B1 bar plus B2 bar B1 is also written as B2 XOR with B1. Now let's see the K-map for G2. That means we have to find the K-map for now for this column. Okay, hence put the first value of 1 in the box 0100. First of all, write B3, B2, B1, B0, 00, 01, 11, 10, 00, 01, 11, 10. First one is for 01, 00, 01, 00. This is the first one. The next one is for 01, 01, 01, 01. Next one is for 01, 10, 01, 10. Next one is for 0111, 0111. Okay. The next one is for 1000, 1000. Next one is for 1001, 1001. Next one is for 1010, 1010. And the last one is for 1011, 1011. The other places having value 0, empty or 0. Here also we get the two chords. Okay, let's simplify this K-map. Here this chord is spread into four columns. Hence the B1 and B0 cancels with each other, and we get the equation of this chord as B3 equal to 0. Hence B3 bar and B 2 is equal to 1, hence we get here B2, that means B3 bar B2. Here in the same case, here B3 equal to 1, hence we write here B3, and B2 equal to 0, hence we write here B2 bar. And we know that B3 bar into B2 plus B3 into B2 bar is equal to B3 XOR with B2. Okay, now let's find the K-map for the next bit G3, that means for this bit G3. Here G3 is 1 for the combination 1000. First of all, write the B3 B2 B1 B0, that means 00 01 11 10, 00 01 11 10. G3 is 1 for 1000, that means for this column. Next one is for 1001, that means 1001. This one is for 1010, 1010. This one is for 1011, 1011. Okay, now this one is for 1100, 1100, that means this box. Next one is for 1101, 1101. The next one is for 1110, 1110. And the last one is for 1111, 1111. The remaining places having the value 0. Now we get here an octet. Now let's find the equation of the octet. Here this octet is spread into the four columns. Hence all the literals are cancelled with each other, and it is spread into the two rows. Hence the B2 changes from 1 to 0, that means it cancels, and we get here B3 only. Hence, G3 is equal to B3. That means after the simplification, we get the equations as G3 equal to B1 XOR with B0, G1 equal to B2 XOR with B1, G2 equal to B3 XOR with B2, and G3 equal to B3. Now we have to draw a logic diagram for this. Okay. Now let consider this is the B3 and we get G3 as it is. Okay. Now we have to find the bit G2. For that purpose, the operation is B3 XOR with P2. That means B3 XOR with, this is the XOR symbol, and we get here G2. This is the B2. Now we have to find G1. The equation of G1 is B2 XOR with B1. That means B2 XOR with the B1. We get here G1. And the last one is G0 is equal to B1 XOR with B0. That means B1 XOR with this B0. We get here G0. This is the logic diagram for binary to gray code converter. Okay. I hope you all understand how to draw the logic diagram and how to find or how to implement the binary to gray code converter. Thank you.